Hi, I'm Paul Sinclair and I'm here to show you how to get your XL2 sound level meter connected to your web browser so that you can see your sound levels and you can receive email alerts if your noise levels are exceeded. For this you need four things. First of all, your XL2 sound level meter, a NetBox with a mobile data modem, and you need to open two websites, the MyNTi Audio product registration website, my.nti-audio.com, and the NoiseScout noise level monitoring website, www.noisescout.com. First, we unpack the NetBox. Comes with a useful set of instructions that show you step by step exactly what we're doing in this video. Here's the NetBox itself. And at the bottom you see serial number, which you should use to register this product at my.nti-audio.com. So let's do that now. Log into MyNTi Audio, select NetBox from the product name list, enter the serial number of your NetBox, and click Register. You see your NetBox now appears in your list of My Products. So let's get the NetBox connected online. There are three possibilities: an Ethernet cable, Wi-Fi stick into one of the USB ports, or a SIM card into the mobile data modem. And for the SIM communication, we need to connect the antenna. To insert the SIM, get yourself a paper clip and pop the tray out simply by pressing on the button next to the tray. SIM card tray comes out. Insert your SIM card and facing down, with the SIM card facing downwards, pop it back into the NetBox. Right, so let's connect up the NetBox and the XL2. We'll take the cable labeled DC in to provide power to the NetBox. Then take the cable labeled XL2 to relay that power further to the XL2. And finally, use the USB XL2 USB port to connect communication to the XL2. When the two devices are connected, it will be indicated on the NetBox by the green light illuminating next to the XL2 label and by the connection symbol on the XL2 screen. To configure the SIM card, we use the screen and the keyboard of the XL2. Scroll to the connection symbol, click, choose settings, mobile data, and now we enter username, password, access point name, and PIN as supplied by your internet service provider. And then we apply settings. Exit. Exit. You notice that the status says preparing, getting IP address, and now we are connected and an IP address has been assigned to the NetBox. The server is now connected, so we can close the screen. The connection is now indicated with a tick mark on the connection status. Okay, next we'll log into NoiseScout, www.noisescout.com. Using the My NTi Audio Details login details. And you'll see immediately that your noise monitor is in your list of My Noise Monitors and the live value because the noise monitor and XL2 are connected already to the system. Live values are coming through. So let's take that noise monitor and add a new job. Just take the default job name, click on the job. If you scroll down, you'll see add a new location to this job. And from the list, you can see our noise monitor available in the list. And straight away, the location pops up with the live value and at this location 1. So let's click on location 1 to go to the detailed view. And if you click and drag the map marker to confirm the location of your monitor, you'll then see that the monitoring switch becomes available to start monitoring. So let's start monitoring. And after about 20 seconds, you'll see data coming in to the screen, which will show up in the last hour detailed data, the 1 second data. If we then scroll back up, you can see here the data. First data came in 16:27:19, and the latest data 16:27:28. And you'll notice that the latest value will update every 10 seconds or so as new data is brought in to the NoiseScout system. The daily audit graph, well, this is data that's logged every 5 minutes, so you'll have to wait a full 5 minute period to see any values on that graph. And this concludes our presentation on how to connect your XL2 to the web browser. In further presentations, we'll go into more details about how to set up your locations for automatic email alerts and alarms. Thank you.